This is the LG Inverter Mini Split Air Conditioner Outdoor Unit Motherboard. It is not powering on at all. As I see this motherboard physically, the capacitors of this motherboard have been damaged due to blown up. The first main fault is these blown up capacitors. I will test this motherboard further to see whether it is repairable. The main electric supply in this motherboard first goes inside this outdoor motherboard and then passes through the indoor motherboard. So I will test this first. A fuse is installed inside this cover. I will check the fuse on these terminals. The fuse is fine. The motherboard also has a main fuse inside it, which is 15 amperes. Let's test this fuse. This fuse is bad because it does not show a beep or a reading in continuity mode on the multimeter. Other than this one, another fuse is also installed in this motherboard. This fuse is installed with a DC blower fan motor circuit. These capacitors' negative trace is attached to the fan motor circuit. So let's check this fuse as well. This fuse is absolutely fine. Now I will change this motherboard's main fuse and these capacitors. I will test the high-sided components in the motherboard, as when the high side of the motherboard has a problem, the low side of the motherboard will not work. I will test these three components installed here. This is a diode installed in this motherboard. This is the IGBT installed here. This is the bridge rectifier. And this is the IPM. I will test the bridge rectifier first. I will put the multimeter on diode mode. I have put the probes on the corner pins of the bridge rectifier. Now the next pins. The bridge rectifier is fine on this side of the polarity of the probes. I have changed the polarity of the probes. The bridge rectifier is absolutely fine. Now I will check the diode. The centered pin of the diode is the cathode and the pin on the sides are the anodes. This diode is fine and has no issue with it. I will check the IGBT by removing the capacitors out of the motherboard. These are the negative pins of the IPM. This one is the positive pin. This is the UV and W pins of this IPM. I have put the negative probe on the negative pin and the positive with the positive pin. Now I will change the polarity of the probes. Now, negative probe on positive and positive probe on negative pins. This pin is showing 0.496 voltage drop on diode mode. The next pin also shows the correct reading. The reading on this pin is fine. The reading on this pin of the IPM is also fine. Now I will remove the capacitors out of the motherboard. I have removed the capacitors from the motherboard now. I will check now whether the IGBT is fine or not. I am attaching the probes of the multimeter between any two pins of the IGBT. It showed a voltage drop and then disappeared. Now, I will check by changing the polarity of the probes. It is also showing the reading fine. I have installed a new capacitor in this motherboard. I didn't install the second capacitor, as I will check it with this single capacitor first. I tested it on series board. The diode in the motherboard sparked. You can see the board has turned black due to that sparking. Two of the diode pins have sparked. I will test the diode again. It is showing a voltage drop as I change the polarity of the probes. The diode in it is also fine. Checking the diode on the other pins as well. It is also fine. It seems to be fine, but it has sparked. I will still change the diode. I have changed the old diode with a new one. You can see the condition of the old diode, it has been short-circuited. But it was looking fine when I checked on the multimeter. When I passed electricity again to the board, then I knew it was short-circuited. Now I will pass the electricity through the motherboard. I am testing it on the series board. The motherboard switching relay is switched on. The LED light of the motherboard has started to blink. Now I will test the motherboard with a proper electricity supply. I have passed electricity through the motherboard. It switched on the relay. Now I will check the voltages on the IPM. 290 volts are flowing between the positive and the negative pin of the IPM. 12.36 volts are on U pin, which is fine. The next two pins also have the same voltages. The IPM is perfectly fine. This means the motherboard has been fixed. Click on the left or right thumbnail to watch our next videos. And subscribe. Thank you.